Hey everybody, I'm Mike from Electric City Sentai DenziCaster, and this week, it's part two of our five-part look at Power Rangers Dino Supercharge. And for some reason, I think I'm about five batteries short. It is part two, the halfway point of our look at Power Rangers Dino Supercharge this week on the DenziBlitz. And better than last week. Thank goodness for that. So we are on, if you have the individual releases of Dino Supercharge, this would have been disc two in the Roar 2-pack. Or we're just on disc two if you've got the full season set like I've got here. So we're looking at episodes 6 through 10 this week, Forged Under Fire, Home Run Coda, Riches and Rags, Besties Forever, and Gone Fishing. And saying the title of episode 9 hurt my feelings a little bit. But anyway, that's what we're looking at this week. So some real quick synopses and then we'll get into stuff here. Forged Under Fire basically introduces the Aqua Ranger in full, his first full episode with the team, Tyler's dad. It serves as a way for him to learn to accept his son and that his son is an adult. Keep in mind, the last time he saw his kid was 8. So now his son is a young man of 18 years and he's the Red Ranger. So he's having to come to terms with that a wee bit. Also establishes that the inner gems themselves can be damaged, which is a pretty interesting concept in the grand scheme of things. Episode 7 is Home Run Coda, where we wind up with a sports monster, and predictably so, we wind up with our sports-themed episode for the season. In this case, Riley trying to live his big league fantasies through his caveman cohort, Coda. Try saying that 3 times fast. And Coda winds up playing for the Amber Beach Earthquakes Major League Baseball team, at least Major League in the Power Rangers universe. Then you wind up with Riches and Rags, essentially an episode where a comical misunderstanding of time-displaced medieval knight leads to the museum owing $2 million to a rather rich individual who basically says, your money or your museum. Then we wind up in episode 9, Besties Forever, the number 4 EVA. I'm a little old for saying that one. But at any rate, the episode revolves around Shelby, our Pink Ranger's best friend, who has this compulsive problem taking credit for everything, as if she did it. Which leads to her taking credit for being the Pink Ranger. And again, hilarity and misunderstandings ensue. And then episode 10, Gone Fishing, where the Rangers are fishing, our core team, while the Red Ranger and the, I guess for want of a better term, the Auxiliary Rangers. So Graphite, Purple, Aqua, and Gold, even though Gold is part of the main team, they wind up searching more for the Silver Energem and the Titanozord that it powers. So that is the crux of this batch of episodes. So let's get into stuff we liked, stuff we didn't like. So one thing that I am surprised I forgot to mention with Disc 1 in Part 1 of this, but I'll mention it now because it plays a part here in this end. We do wind up with a new general, and the new general we wind up meeting is called Singe. Now, one thing that's interesting to me here is that we have seen Curio and Poissandra at the beginning of the season and in the first couple of episodes, but past that, they kind of disappear, and we are left with Fury, Singe, who is our new general, and Wrench, and they are the central generals for Heckle. Curio and Poissandra, who I want to call Candarella because that, if I'm not mistaken, that was her name in Curiouger. But they wind up, like I said, just kind of fading away for a little bit. So that, I'm wondering if they will revisit that. I know what happens with those two characters in Curiouger, and I'm going to be curious to see if they fall into a similar situation here in Dino Supercharge. Singe is the fifth Chevlar from Curiouger, whose Sentai name escapes me, but essentially, if I'm not mistaken, he's the Chevlar of Regret. And if you look at him, you can see that he has the same mask icon, the same emotional mask, like the drama masks of tragedy and comedy. So, pretty interesting character. I do like him. They very much show him as having an ulterior motive. And all the way up to when we get to episode 10, he serves a different master. The question mark is he working directly for Sledge? Is there another bad guy? One of the things that Saban, in specific, but Power Rangers in general, has always been pretty darn good about is using all the monster costumes, all the resources, all the giant mecha fights, everything that they can, which means that we're still missing the actual big bad from Curiouger. In Curiouger, the main bad guy was named Chaos, and he worked for the DeBoss, was the bad guy organization, faction, team name. But it'll be interesting to see, is this making way for Chaos, or whatever they'll call him in this version? Is this making way for DeBoss itself, you know, or again, whatever they call it in this version? What is going to be the deal? We've only got 10 episodes left to find out. But I really do like Singe as a character, and I like that they play him almost from Jump Street as having an ulterior motive. There's something to this guy that is just odd. In this batch of episodes, essential episodes that I think need to be watched, Forged Under Fire, if for no other reason than it really kind of solidifies and serves as almost a part two to Roar of the Red Ranger, episode 5, where it completes the relationship reunion between Tyler and his dad. So I like that. Home Run Coda is just a fun episode. Is it essential? Probably not. But it's really, really fun. Riches and Rags is a story that it's the time displaced character story and a misunderstanding that leads to something. But it does show that our villains can make hybrid monsters using elements from two previously destroyed monsters. We've seen that they can take part of a previously destroyed monster and restore it and basically regenerate the monster. But they've never shown until now they can take parts from two different monsters and regenerate them together into a new, more powerful form. That's what they do in Riches and Rags. So, interesting from that standpoint. Again, do you have to watch it? Probably not. And in point of fact, if they ever come back to that idea that they can take two dead monsters and make one more powerful living monster, I'll frankly be a little surprised. Besties Forever, I frankly couldn't stand the episode. It seemed very contrived, to be honest. Like all shows of targeting children, there tends to be a moral somewhere in it, and this one it's don't take credit for things you didn't do, which is a very interesting moral tale to give. You know, we get the morality in each one of these, so to speak, but that's the moral lesson in this episode. But the episode itself just felt very weak to me. So nothing great, nothing horrible. Just it didn't feel like something you'd have to watch. Gone Fishing, you have to watch. If for no other reason than it is the first appearance of the Silver Ranger, we find out the Silver Ranger is in space somewhere. That the Silver Energem somehow found its way into outer space. I'm not sure how in the world that happened, but that's where it is nonetheless. And our Silver Ranger has told us that the Titanozord has gone back to being dormant because of the distance between them. Interesting concept. If you put enough distance between an Energem and its guardian Zord, apparently the Zord will go dormant. Who knew? We have got the first look at the Silver Ranger morphed, so we don't know what he looks like outside of the costume, but we also get the Titanozord in this episode, and it serves as a bit of a Green Ranger focus with Riley interacting with his brother, and your moral tale of this one is brothers argue, but at the end of the day, you're still family. So I really like Singe as a new villain. We've seen now the Battleizer, Dino Supercharge Red for a few episodes. There was one really cringeworthy line in here if you are a Super Sentai fan, where Singe makes the remark, something along the lines of you walking carnival when he's spouting off one-liners towards Red during a fight. That being the name of that form in Kyuriudra. It's Kyuriu Red Carnival. So, yeah. Or it's a Kyuriu Red Carnival or just Kyuriu Carnival. But either way, it's the carnival form is what they call it in Kyuriudra. And it's just, if I didn't know Kyuriudra, I probably wouldn't have found it as horrible a line. I found it groan-worthy here. And I probably would have just thought it was stupid otherwise because there's nothing about it that infers a carnival. But I digress. The debut of the Titanozord, I thought was pretty cool. Looking forward to seeing what they do with it from here on in. And then, realistically, I will say this. It's still, so far this season, 10 episodes in, still is not as strong as its predecessor. It's still not as strong as Dino Charge. But it has my attention, and I do want to see what happens next. Heckle steals the show whenever he's on screen. So I really am liking Heckle. And I like the fact that Heckle, as a leader, is actually fairly intelligent and fairly decisive. Snide, they're showing, you see more and more of this very distinct difference between the two characters, where Snide is more of your atypical Power Rangers villain, which is to say that if brute force isn't working, you're not using enough, and that he operates from this almost constant state of irritation, and is very emotional. Whereas Heckle is actually operating on a more intellectual level as a villain. I kind of dig that. And you see that he doesn't pull punches. You actually see that in episode one, where he says, anyone that doesn't want to follow me can leave. And one of the monsters goes, well, I really don't want to follow you, and goes to leave. He destroys the monster himself in front of everybody without transforming into Snide. Just Heckle shoots lasers at him and kills him. Here in this disc, we see Singe takes a shot at him when the jig is up, and we realize that he's not loyal to Heckle, but we also see Heckle ordering Fury the next time you see Singe destroy him. So now we're getting a little infighting among the villains in earnest. Not just bickering, but actual fighting internally amongst our bad guys. So I want to see where that goes. Realistically, there's not too much farther you can go with the storyline of our heroes. which I kind of hate to say at this point. There's been a brewing love story between Shelby and Tyler, our Pink and Red Rangers, that should be resolved at some point, I would hope. But that really is the only story arc for our heroes that's left as an emotional story arc. I still kind of stick to my guns that I think they revealed the dad a little early. But with that said, let's see what they got left, because there's a lot of elements of Kyuriger they still haven't touched. They still haven't touched Torin. We still haven't seen the Silver Ranger. They still haven't used DeBoss. They still haven't used Chaos. So there's a lot of elements of Kyuriger that are still on the table. And I'm kind of, that's what I'm really looking forward to. And there's a spoiler, so to speak, on the back of the box. If you don't want to be spoiled at all, never read the back of these things. But there's a spoiler on the back that kind of would logically allude. And I stayed away from a lot of spoilers to do this very series. So I don't know what happened in Dino Charge. But there's this thing that alludes to, in Kyuriger, there were technically 11 Kyuriger's. So there's something here that alludes to potentially the 11th one. So who knows? Could there be an 11th Dino Charge Ranger? So we're going to find out together. So 10 episodes left. When next we meet, we're going to be on Disc 3, which is the first half of the Extinction 2-part set, if you bought this in separate packages. We're going to be looking at episodes 11 through 15. That's Love at First Fight, Catching Some Rays, Recipe for Disaster, Silver Secret, and Wings of Danger. That sounds promising, actually. So I'm really looking forward to it. To see what comes up next here in Dino Supercharged. So far, I am entertained, and this is, if nothing else, I'm enjoying spending more time with the characters that I enjoyed so thoroughly and that I became invested in Dino Charge, and I'm digging Heckle. So let's see what's to come. We're halfway home. In 2 weeks' time, we will have wrapped up Dino Supercharged. So that means we are really, really close to engaging back into the world of Metal Heroes with Space Sheriff Scheider. That's coming up in just a few weeks here on the DenziBlitz. I'm looking forward to that as well. For our buddy Ruslig, who may or may not be watching, and I say may or may not because we're not talking about a Metal Hero at the moment, but in case you are watching, I'm still trying to find Space Sheriff Sharavan to get out there as well. If you'd like to help us out here at the ECS Network, here at DenziBlitz and DenziCaster, or any of the other great shows here on the channel, Rage Quit Radio, 8-Star Anime, Chop Saki Cinema, and so on, hop over to our Cafe Press store. It's cafepress.com/ECS Network. You can pick yourself up a nifty t-shirt, kind of like the one I'm wearing right now. Or you can head over to our Patreon page. That is patreon.com/ECS Network. We got one level, folks, and it's $1 a month. And, you know, many hands make light work. We're trying to raise money. We need to hit $100 at the moment in order to be able to get another couple of lighting rigs. They're $50 a piece for our other two shows, for Chop Saki Cinema and 8-Star Anime, for our other two prime shooting locations. So that's our next thing on the agenda, as it were. So looking forward to trying to get that done as well, and you guys can help, so please feel free to do so. And I'm also in the process of picking out what's going to be our next patron-exclusive DenziBlitz episode. It's been a while since I did one, mainly because we didn't have any patrons, but we do now! And so I've got a DenziBlitz special in mind. I just have to figure out what it is. It probably will be Gavin and Decca Ranger, because that was the one I promised would be next when I did the first one. So look forward to that too if you're one of our patrons. Those don't air here on the YouTube channel. So folks, I want to thank you very kindly for joining us this week. Until next time, when we will be going through episodes 11 through 15 of Dino Charge, Dino Supercharge. I'm Mike, and we'll see you around.